past perfect tense in Marathi. Second style. We have long back learned past perfect tense. Today we will see another style of saying past perfect tense. With the grammar learnt before, the sentence I had spoken will be translated as me bolelo hoto. In second style, it can be said as me bolelelo. In this form, suffixes are appended to verb and the form of verb to be, that is asne, is not required. If verb is akarmak, that is which does not need noun, then suffix is chosen based on gender pluralism of karta, that is doer of action. If the verb is sakarmak, that is which needs noun, then suffix is chosen based on gender and pluralism of karma, that is noun. Let's see the suffixes. I will just say the pronoun in Marathi and required suffix. Me for masculine, lelo. Me for feminine, lele. We, amhi, lelo. Apan, to. Tu, lelas. Tu, feminine, lelis. Tumhi, lelat. To, lela. Ti, leli. Te, lele. Te, lele. Tya, lelya. Ti, leli. Let's see examples which will make it clear. First, examples of akarmak verb. I had spoken. Me, bolalelo. You had danced. Tu, nachalelas. You had danced. Tu, nachalelis. He had laughed. To, hasalela. They boys had laughed. Te mulge hasalele. Let's see examples of sakarmak verb. So the prefix will be, suffix will be decided based on the noun and gender of noun. I had opened door. Me darwaja ughadlela. I had opened window. Me khidki ughadleli. She had eaten mango. Tine amba khallela. Those girls picked keys. Tya mulini killya uchalelelya. Here door is masculine, so we used prefix lela. Window, that is khidki, is feminine, so we used suffix leli. Mango is masculine, so we use suffix la, lela, so it becomes khallela. Ki, that is killi, is feminine and multiples of ki is killya. So we use the suffix for feminine plural, it is lelya. So the verb become uchalelelya. Thank you.